caught up in your presence. I just wanna sit here at your feet. I'm caught up in this holy moment. I never wanna leave. Oh, here for blessings, Jesus, you don't owe me anything, more than anything that you can do. I just want you. I'm sorry when I've just gone through the motions. I'm sorry when I just sang another song. Take me back to where we started. I open up my heart to you. I'm sorry when I've come with my agenda. I'm sorry when I forgot that you're enough. Take me back to where we started. I open up my heart to you. I'm caught up in your presence. I'm caught up in this holy moment. I never wanna leave. Oh, I'm not here for blessings. Jesus, you don't owe me anything. And more. I just want you and nothing else, and nothing else, nothing else will do. I just want you and nothing else, and nothing else, nothing else will do. Just wanna bless your heart, Jesus.
I just wanna speak the name of Jesus over every heart and every mind. 'Cause I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus. I just wanna speak the name of Jesus till every dark addiction starts to break, declaring there is hope and there is freedom. I speak Jesus. 'Cause your name is power, your name is healing, your name is life. Break every stronghold, shine through the shadows, burn light.
Hey, Coosa Valley family, thank y'all so much this morning for joining us. We are so glad that you are here via live stream, and we're sorry that we can't be together this morning in service, but due to sickness, we thought it'd be best that we just join on the web this morning. So thank you guys, you're awesome. We know that that this is different, but we know that God can still move in the very same way that he does when we're together in church, as he does when we are at our homes, in our cars, wherever we are watching. So church, thank y'all. We love y'all. We're praying for you guys, for the guys, the people who are sick. We're praying for you as well. And church, this morning, we just want to remind you that there's many ways to watch. If you are watching live stream, you can watch on Facebook, you can watch on Instagram, YouTube. We have Boxcast. And we also, if you want to watch later, we have a podcast that you can look at. And there's so many avenues, so many ways to get involved and to watch and to get plugged into our service. And it's just so many ways. So we thank y'all. And as well, if you want to give, if you want to say, Brother Michael, I want to give, but we're not in church. Well, guess what? We have online giving. It's awesome. It's easy. All you have to do is go to cvcog.church, click on giving, and everything is right there. The information to give and give to God, and it's right there. So this morning, we're going to pray before we get into worship and the word. And so let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you today. Thank you for, Lord, giving us, Lord, this day, our daily bread. Thank you for giving us this day, just the very breath for us to breathe, to be together, Lord. I know we're not together in person, but we're together, Lord, on the internet, in live stream, God, Lord. And I pray that, Lord, as we gather this morning, Lord, via live stream, you pour out your same anointing, pour out your same spirit on us, God, as we worship and praise you, because you are worthy to be praised, God. I know that we're not together, but God, we can still lift our hands. We can still praise you. We can still lift our voices to you this morning. And I pray, Lord God, as we move into this service, as we go into it, Lord, as Sister Elizabeth leads us in worship, God, that, Lord, you will, Lord, pour out your spirit on us in every single way and pour out your anointing on her as she leads, God. Lord, and I pray, Lord, as Lord the pastor, as Brother Andy, Lord, presents the word and gives the word that you have for us, that, Lord, you will, Lord, let it come alive in us. And Lord, let it come so that we can, Lord, take it in and feed off of it and learn and grow and leave changed than we came this morning, changed than when we first started this stream, God. And I pray, Lord, that you just, Lord, move in our lives in a mighty way. Lord, let this week be a week of change, of greatness, God, Lord, of blessings, Lord God. And I pray that, Lord, that you, Lord, be shown as the light, Lord, in our lives to every person we meet this week. God, I pray that you just, Lord, use us to be, Lord God, to as your voice today. Use us as your voice this week, this month, and the rest of this year. God, we love you. We thank you, God. But Lord, we also pray for our church family. Lord, you see the ones battling the sickness. You see the ones that are not able to be there because they're just sick, God. Lord, whatever the sickness may be, whether COVID or not, God, you see what it is. And I know that, Lord, you are the ultimate healer. You are the one, Lord, who can meet all needs, God. So whatever the need may be this morning for whoever's listening, watching, God, Lord, I pray that, Lord, you go and meet the need this morning right now in Jesus' name. God, I know and I pray that you, Lord, let your healing go. Lord, let your healing touch our church this morning. And Lord, we love you. We praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Church, thank y'all this morning. We love y'all, and let's worship this morning.
There's nothing worth more that could ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living God. Your presence, Lord. I taste
God, we just thank you that you are our healer, Lord. God, we thank you that you're with us in every situation that we face. God, you're in every trial, you're in every circumstance. God, I pray that you would just wrap every single one of us in your arms this morning, Jesus, that you would meet every need, God, according to your will. God, we know that you can do exceedingly and abundantly all that we could ever ask or think. So, God, this morning, we ask that you be a healer where it's needed, be a provider where it's needed. God, I pray that as we move into the preaching of your word, God, that we would have open ears, open hearts, God, and that we would receive from you today.
It's as if we've wandered the desert, travelers without a home, together yet alone in this uncertainty. An uncommon time, unexpected, undefined, binds us, unites us, does not divide us, but reminds us of who we are. A body, not a building, unrelenting, unyielding, persevering, revealing the faithfulness of God. Maybe this virus has started a fire inside us, ignited us, inspired us to live louder, love harder, care deeper. 6 feet, 6 miles, or a world apart. Our calling remains the same. For we are the body of Christ.
Coosa Valley family, I want to thank you again for all of your prayers over the last couple of days. Things have been great. It's been a slow process, but healing quite nicely, but just want to thank you for that. Also, we want to, as we are getting started this morning, we're going to go to the Lord in prayer and ask God again one more time to touch our service today. And we're also praying for each one of our church family. We know that we've got many that are connected with the church that are sick. To let you know, some have got COVID, some have got sickness, and so we just want to be praying for each of those. The reason I make a distinction between COVID and sickness is because that's what's on everybody's mind, and so I just want to make sure that you're aware that there are some that have tested positive, some that are waiting for tests. However, there are some that are just sick, and so just sicknesses that are going on, and we want to be much in prayer for each one of those. If you have a prayer request, please text it to the church at 205-642-8744. We'll stop, take a moment right now. If you've got a prayer request, please text it to us at 205-642-8744. We do want to be praying for you and with you. We want to partner with each other in prayer, and we want to hold each other up to God in prayer. So if you have a prayer request, please text it to the number 205-642-8744, or you can visit our website at cvcog.church. You can click on prayer request, and you can submit prayer requests there as well. Let's go to God in prayer and ask God to minister in our time of devotion this morning. I think that this is something that we really need to hear today, here in our lives today. And so we want to ask God to minister in our time of Bible study this morning. Dear kind and gracious Heavenly Father, as we come to today, again, we want to thank you. Thank you for the blessings that you've given us. Thank you for this great opportunity and the wonderful technology and the tools that we have that we're able to, Brother Michael and Sister Elizabeth are able to open up our service and lead us in song, and then we're able to bring forth your word this morning, and we're able to broadcast it on our live stream to where that whether our church family whether they're at home or they're in the car or they're on the back porch drinking a cup of coffee, wherever they may be, Father, I'm praying and I'm thankful that we're able to be there with them. And God, over the next few moments, I pray that your Holy Spirit would just resonate, not only here in this office, but in our on our live stream. Father, I pray that you will touch and minister to each heart and each life that is represented by our body of believers. Father, I praise you and I thank you because I know you're able to move and I know you're able to minister. And God, I praise you right now for every blessing that you've given us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. A title, if you would this morning, is going to be How God Associates with His People. How God Associates with His People. And I think that this is something that we really need to hear. We need to understand that even in the midst of the storms that we've been facing, whether it be health issues, whether it be death, whether it be coronavirus, whether it be any type of sickness, whether it be kidney stones, you know who you are, whatever the case may be, God still associates with His people, and God still wants to work with His people. And so if you have your Bibles, if you will, turn with us to the book of Revelation, chapter 21. Book of Revelation, chapter 21. I want to read verses 1 through 4 this morning. All of these scriptures is going to come out of the King James Version. And so I'm just telling you that so you'll know exactly where we're at. We're going to have the, here in just a moment, we'll have the just the references pop up on the screen. But I want us to really take our Bibles and really look at what the Word says this morning. Take your highlighter and highlight it. Oh, Brother Andy, we're used to the scriptures being on the screens and not having to pick up our Bibles. And I think that that's what we really need to do today, is we really need to pick up our sword, and we really need to pick up our sword of faith and our shield of faith and our sword of the Word, and we really need to stand on what God is telling us. And so take your Bible, whether it's your Bible or even if it's your cell phone, take your Bible this morning and follow along with us today. Revelation chapter 21, starting in verse 1, reading verses 1 through 4, and it says this: And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there were no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a giant voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with man, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, no more sorrow, no more crying. I'm throwing in no more sickness, no more pain, for the former things are passed away. In our text that we've just read, we see how that God himself associates with us, his people, in the future. But we want to take a deeper look at that, and we want to see how God associates with us and how God resonates with his people. And in order to do that, we can take a look at Acts chapter 9. We find in Acts chapter 9, verses 4 and 5, that there's an earthly ministry that Jesus did. And he, in that ministry, he associated with his people, with you and I, closely. Yes, I know that we was not there when Jesus was walking around on earth. Boy, wouldn't it have been something to have seen Jesus turn the water into the wine? Wouldn't it have been something to see Jesus healing the leper and the leper getting up to walk again? Wouldn't it have been something to see him causing the blinded eyes to see, the dumb ears to hear, and the deaf ears to hear, and the dumb to talk. Wouldn't it have been awesome to have seen that? And so we see, but we want to take a look and see what Jesus did. In his earthly ministry, he associated very closely with his people. And in that, we're going to look at Acts chapter 9, verses 4 and 5, and we see, it says this, "And he fell to earth and heard a voice saying, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? And he said, Who are you, Lord? And the Lord said, I am Jesus, whom thou persecuted. It is hard for thee to kick against the pricks." You know, in all of the things that Jesus did and all the ways that Jesus associated with us, even in after everything he did, Saul still persecuted. We see this today. We see the things that God does through his people. We see the things God does for his church, for his people, to those around us. We see the way that God works through his pastors and his Sunday school teachers and his evangelists. And we see how God associates very closely with us when we come into the house of God and we hear the songs uplifting us in praise. We see how God associates with us whenever we come to an altar and we say, God, I need your touch one more time. This is something that I'm facing. This is something I'm going through. I need a special touch one more time. We see how God associates, and yet just today, just like Saul did, we see how that persecution still comes against Christ, still comes against Christ's body, still comes against Christ's church. But Jesus tells Saul, he says, why are you persecuting me? Why are you coming against me? Look at all the things that I've done for you. Look at the things that I've done for my people. Jesus has done so much for us. Why do we come against him? Well, Brother Andy, how do I come against him? Well, you remember that Tuesday night that you really wanted to go out and Christ was really calling you to do a time of prayer at home? Believe it or not, that's a time of persecution. What about that Sunday morning? Now, I realize today that we're not able to be there, but we're able to join together on live stream. Well, it's live stream, and I really don't have to do it. Nobody will know. I can go and do my thing, and I can watch it later. It'd be okay. Well, those are those times of persecutions. That Saturday night, whenever we really need to be getting things ready to come to the house of God, and we go and do our own thing, and wind up sleeping late on Sunday morning because they're just going to do live stream, so it's not a big deal. Those are those times of persecution. Why is it persecution? Because God not only wants to associate with us on Sunday mornings, Sunday night, Wednesday nights, during a time of prayer, but he wants to be with us at all times. He wants to have communion with us. He wants to be with us. He wants to love on us. He wants to be a part of our lives. So let's stop and take a moment about that. How does God associate with us? How does God want to be with us? Well, first of all, we find that Christ wants to really be with us. He just wants to be with his people. Take a look at Matthew chapter 1 and verse 23, and it says, "Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel," which is being interpreted, God with us. Church, God wants to be with us. During those times of heartache, God wants to be with us. During those times when we're sick and running a fever, God wants to be with us. During the times that we're having a great and wonderful time and things are going good, God wants to be with us. That time that we got fired from work, God wants to be with us. That time that we're going through heartache and trial, God wants to be with us. That time that we're trying to pass a kidney stone, God wants to be with us. That time that we're having procedures in the hospital, that time that we've had a death in the family, that time that we've been sick with coronavirus, that time that we didn't know what was going to happen tomorrow, God wants to be with us. Every step of the way, God wants to be with us. He does not just want to say, you know, he doesn't want to just throw us out to the wolves and say, fend for yourself. But he wants to be with us. He wants to lead us and guide us and direct our path. He wants to be a part of our lives. God wants to be with us. You know, we can also take a look at John chapter 1, verse 1 and verse 14, and it says, in the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. You know, the thing about it is whether it's on your phone or you go back and you grab your Bible. This is His Word. This is the Word of God. This is the very essence and the presence of God in our lives. And what we need to understand is in the very beginning, and I know that this is speaking of the time of creation, but you know what? In the beginning of your problems was the Word. The Word was God. The Word was with God. The Word was God. In the beginning of your trial, the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. The Word was God. In the beginning of your sickness, your heartache, the death that you're facing, in the midst of your trials, your persecution, your tribulation, the sorrows that you're facing, in the beginning of all of those things, the Word of God wants to be with us. Brother Andy, what am I supposed to do? How am I supposed to be able to get a hold of God? Well, open up His Word, and He wants to speak to you. Why? Because in verse 14 of John chapter 1, He says, the Word was made flesh, and He dwelt among us. He was full of grace and full of truth. All of the things that we face, all of the persecution, all of the trials, everything we go through, God wants to be with us. His Word has been made flesh, and He wants to dwell with us every step of the way. God wants to be with us. So in that, we also find that in our conversion, God is in us. So not only does God want to be with us, but God wants to be in us. Take a look at, and I know that it shouldn't surprise anybody, I know I've got a lot of scriptures here, but 2 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 16, it says, and what agreement hath the temple of God with idols? For you are the temple of the living God, and God has said, I will dwell in them and walk in them. I will be their God, and they shall be my people. I don't know about you, but I'm glad to know that God is for me. God wants to be with me. God is in me. God wants me to be His people, and He wants to be my God. You know, the thing about it is no matter what we have faced, no matter what we've gone through, no matter the persecution, the trials, the tribulation, no matter all the sicknesses and the death, all of those things, God wants to be with us. He wants to be our God. He wants to dwell with us. We can also find in 1 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 19, it says, what, know you not that your body is the temple of God? For the Holy Ghost which is in you, you are not your own. You have been bought with a price. You know, if I bought something, I bought my car, I bought my truck, they can't get up and go do whatever they want to do by themselves. They got to have me with them. Why? Because they need the key. They need a key to crank them up and get them to moving. Well, church, the thing about it is this should be our key. This should be the key that we're holding on to. This should be the key that we're leaning on, that we're trusting in, that we're asking God to be a part of our life. We need God in us to crank us and to motivate us. We've been bought with a price. It's time that we start acting like we belong to Him. Yes, I know that there's sicknesses and there's death and there's things that we face. All of these things that goes on in our lives, there's not a thing we can do to stop that. But there is a thing that we can do to hold on to the mighty hand of God and allow God, because He's bought us, He cares for us, He's wanting to take care of our every need. the birds of the air doesn't worry about the food that they eat or the clothing on their back. The Son of, as children of God, we don't have to worry about where is the next thing coming from, because the Bible tells us, never seen the righteous forsaken, nor the, his seed begging for bread. God is going to take care of us. Why? Because in all circumstances, God is all around us. Psalms chapter 125 and verse 2 says, as the mountains are around about Jerusalem, so the Lord is around about his people, hence even forevermore. The mountains is Israel's protection. The mountains that are all around of Jerusalem, of Israel, these mountains are for the protection of the city, of the country. Guess what? God has his angels, has his mountain around us. He has the sword and he has the protection and the shield. He has his angels encamped around us. We are never under circumstances that God does not want to be there with us. The only time that God is not right by our side is when we've left God and said, I can handle this on my own. You know what, church? I can't handle it on my own. I can't face days on my own. I can't face trials and sickness and death. I can't face these things on my own. I need God to encamp around me so that I know that God, no matter what fate, what goes on, no matter what we face, no matter the trials, no matter what we go through, God is going to take care of us every step of the way. Why? Because in all circumstances, God is around us. And in the church, God is among us. We find in Matthew chapter 18 and verse 20, for where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them. Church, today, right now, I know that we're not together under one roof. We're not sitting in the sanctuary. You can see this. I'm in my office. You see the books behind me. You see some knickknacks on the shelves. You see that I'm here in my office. I'm not with you right now. Some of you are sitting on your back porch drinking a cup of coffee, your front porch. Some may be in your RV. Some may be sitting on the side of the lake. Some may be in a boat. Some may be in your living room. Some may be in the vehicle going down the road. Wherever you may be, we are a part of the church, the body of Christ. And guess what? God is among us. When it is noised about that Jesus is in the house, people will come. There's something special about God calling his people together. Yes, I know we're not under one roof, but the Bible plainly tells us, forsake not the assembling of ourselves together. We've assembled together today. This is the 11 o'clock hour on a Sunday. This is a time where we've joined together via live stream to be able to worship and praise God. Well, you know what, church? We are together. Why? Because we've joined together with brothers and sisters of like faith watching this live stream together. We know that there are some that are hurting. There's some that are sick. There's some that are depressed. There's some that have anxiety. There's some that are facing trials and they need a healing in their body. There's some that needs a special touch from the top of their head to the soles of their feet. We need God. You know what? God is in his church and we are his church. We may not be at 970 River Road, Cropwell, Alabama, but we are together. We can hold one another up. We may be apart by mileage, but we're together. Why? Because we're able to text into the church and say, God, Pastor, I need a touch. I need a prayer. I've got a prayer request. We're able to send that prayer request out. On occasion, we send those prayer requests out to the body because the body is able to pray one with another. We're still the body. We're still the church of God. Again, not the denomination, but the church that God has called us to be. Why? Because in conflict, God is for us. Romans chapter 8 and 31, what shall we say to these things? If God be for us, the DAL version says, who really cares who's against us? In conflict, in trial, in sickness, and in health, in the good, in the bad, the ups and downs of life. All things God is for us. At the first time the servant saw the enemy was greater, God opened his eyes and he saw that there were more all around. That's found in 2 Kings chapter 6, 14 through 17. When he looked up into the mountains and he looked all around, he encompassed all around. He saw horses and he saw chariots and he says, what in the world are we going to do? And Elijah prayed, and I prayed he opened his eyes. And the Lord, in verse 17 of 2 Kings chapter 6, says, and the Lord opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw, and behold, the mountains were full of horses and chariots of fire all around about them. You know, church, I pray that God opens all of our eyesights, because we need to know that God is all around us. In the middle of the conflict, God is there for us. In the middle of sickness, God is for us. In the middle of every circumstance that we face, God is for us. You know what? You and God together, you make up a majority in the middle of whatever's going on. There is no one can be greater than the God that lives inside of you. I'm so glad that God is for us. God is with us. God is right there with us every step of the way. In crisis, God is beneath us. Deuteronomy, oh yeah, I'm sure some of the teenagers just laughed right then. Deuteronomy chapter 33 and 27, the eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms, and he shall thrust out the enemy from before thee, and shall say, destroy them. When someone, an older person, is dying and said she is sinking fast, she's revived long enough to answer, how can you sink when you stand on the solid rock? You know, in the middle of whatever we're going through, whatever you're facing this morning, whatever the circumstances that you're going through, we're not all facing the same thing. I know that we've mentioned it time and time again, but some are facing sickness, some are facing death, some have faced persecution, some have faced all sorts of issues in our lives. Some is not health, some is spiritual, some is emotional, psychological, mental, physical, spiritual, whatever it may be. In all of our crisis, God has a solid foundation beneath us. All we've got to do is stand on it. He's a solid rock in whatever's going on in your life. We need to stand on him. We need to trust in him. We need to depend on him, church. Why? Because no matter what goes on, the gates of hell will not prevail against the solid rock of God. With care, God is also above us. This is the last thought. Deuteronomy chapter 33 and verse 12. Benjamin said, the beloved of the Lord shall dwell in the safety by him, and the Lord shall cover him and cover him all the day long, and he shall dwell between his shoulders. I'm so glad to know that God is beneath us, but God is also above us. God is all around us. He's got his soldiers. He's got his army around us. God has got his word beneath us, the solid rock. And God is above us. Whatever you're facing today, whatever you're going through, please know you're not in this alone. Not only does God given you a church family to help you, to pray with you, to be a part of your life, but God is for you. God is with you. God is beneath you. God's above you. God cares about you. In our conflict, God is for us. So church, whatever you're facing, whatever you're going through, please know that God is for you today. Would you bow your heads one more time and let's pray? As you're bowing your heads, again, remember, I want you to take your phones right now. I know that we've bowed our heads and we're fixing to go to God in prayer, but I want you to take your phones right now. I want you to open up your text app. I want you to dial this number, 205-642-8744. And church, if you have a need, whatever that need be may be, would you just text it? Text whatever that need may be to the church. That's the church number. It goes into a small group of our pastoral staff and our church leadership to where that we're praying for you and with you, whatever the need may be. If you want it private for just my eyes only, start it off with Pastor Andy. And then text me whatever that need may be. I'm telling you, God is wanting to touch your life today. Whatever the need may be, God is able. We'll give you just a moment to do that. Send in your prayer request, because I'm telling you, God wants to move in your life. Whatever that need is, God is able. Now, if you've done with your prayer request, now I want you to, still with your text, I want you to do one more thing. I want you to dial that number one more time in your text app. I know this sounds silly. Some people may think this sounds so foolish, but I want you to join with me to this. I mean, it's taking a step of faith. Now I want you to text this. I'm praying for my church family. I'm praying for my church family. I want you to send that in. Because I'm going to tell you something. As we're taking a step of faith, wherever we may be, we're all across and wherever every part. Whether you've texted in, you can also comment on the live feed, wherever you may be watching, whether it be YouTube or Facebook, Instagram, wherever you may be. I'm telling you, God is wanting to see, are you willing to trust in Him with whatever the need is? I'm telling you, God is able to do abundantly above all that we could ever hope or imagine. As you've texted in your prayer request and you've texted in that you're going to be praying for our church family, just please know that we're praying for you. Whatever the need may be, I know that God is able. Amen? As we're fixing to go to God in prayer, remember there's several announcements connected with our church. We've got several things going. Those announcements are on all of our social medias. We're going to keep those coming out via text and via our emails, so make sure that you've signed up for that. If you're not getting the text and you're not getting the emails, be sure to text. As you text the number, as I just gave it to you, 205-642-8744. If you want to sign up for the email, make sure you text your email address there as well, and we'll sign you up for that. Also, if you're getting text and you want to make changes to what you're getting, you want more, you want less, type the word change. We'll send out what you're getting and what you are not getting, and that way you can respond and get that accordingly, and so that way we can make sure you're receiving everything that you are wanting to get. You can also visit our CV Connect page at cvcog.church/connect, and that way you can sign up for all that information there as well. All of our avenues of connection is found there on the CV Connect page. Please be sure to share this on your Facebook page, share the YouTube, share on the social media so that others can be able to watch and be a part of what God is doing here at Coosa Valley. Also, as Brother Michael mentioned in the beginning, I know that we want to be praying over our tithes and our offerings. Brother Andy, I wanted to give today. We're not able to be there. That's okay. We do have online giving that is found at cvcog.church/give. You can also come by the church. There's a drop box at the drive-thru. We do have a camera on that, just letting you know. Also, we do check that box on a regular basis, so you're welcome to come by and you're welcome to drop anything into that box, and God will bless you as well. We also have our online giving where you can. We have the Cash App, we have PayPal, we have Text to Give, and our online giving. So all of that information is found at cvcog.church/give. Be sure to visit there as well. Let's go to God in prayer, and we'll be dismissed this morning. Thank you so much for being a part of what God is doing here at Coosa Valley. Dear kind and gracious Heavenly Father, again today, we want to thank you for the blessings that you've given us. Thank you for this wonderful, great opportunity that you've allowed us to join together and worship you over our live stream. Father, I pray that as something has been said today, I pray that it would resonate into the hearts and lives of those that are watching. I pray, Father God, through the song and through the sermon, Father, I pray that encouragement is given into the lives of each one that's joined us today. Father, I pray that you'll touch those that are sick, that touch those that need a special touch from you. Father, I pray that you'll minister in a mighty way to every life, every heart, every life that's joined with us today. And God, I thank you for what you've done and what you're going to continue to do. In Jesus' precious name we pray, amen and amen. Continue to keep a close watch on our social media, our text, our email concerning Wednesday's service. We'll make that decision closer to time. We want to make sure that we keep everyone safe, and we want to keep everybody taken care of. So just please, if you're sick, please stay home when we do open back up. But we also want to remind you to keep a watch on our social media, our text, our email, so that you'll know what's happening around the church. May the good Lord bless you is our prayer. Thank you so much for being a part of what God is doing here at Coosa Valley. May God bless you is our prayer. Amen and amen.
I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus. I just want to speak the name of Jesus till every dark addiction starts to break, declaring there is hope and there is freedom. I speak Jesus, 'cause your name is power, your name is healing, your name is life. Break every stronghold, shine through the shadows, burn like a fire. Just wanna speak the name of Jesus over fear and all anxiety, to every soul held captive by depression. I speak Jesus. Your name is power. Your shout Jesus from the mountains, Jesus in the streets, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name, Jesus. Shout Jesus from the mountains, Jesus in the streets, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name, Jesus. Shout Jesus from the mountains, and Jesus in within his presence. I speak